all. Today we will learn about types of epithelial tissue. In last class we have discussed epithelial tissue and their examples. So let's discuss with types of epithelial tissue. Basically, epithelial tissue is divided into two types, that is simple and compound. And simple is further divided into many types, that is squamous epithelium, choroidal epithelium, columnar epithelium, pseudostratified epithelium. So what is the definition of simple epithelium tissue? That is, single layer of cells are present in simple epithelium tissue. There would be single layer of cell. And what is the function of simple epithelium tissue? That it provides secretion absorption sensation etc. It is the work of simple epithelium tissue. If we talk about compound epithelium tissue, its definition is two or more layer of cells are present there, and the function of compound epithelium tissue is the protection, as we found in our skin. And where protection is needed, there compound epithelium is formed. So let's discuss with the simple epithelial tissue. Simple epithelial tissue is formed in the as a lining for body cavity. It will form on the lining of body cavity, ducts and tubes. Where would be lining of body cavity? As in blood vessel, as in the wall of heart, there would be simple epithelium will be present. And if we talk about body cavity, that is esophagus, where will be hollow like structure, there would be formed simple epithelial tissue. And ducts, it is also found in glands, means glands are of two types, exocrine and endocrine, so it would be found there. And tubes. Tubes like alimentary canal, alimentary canal is a tube-like structure. So it would be found in simple epithelial tissue. Simple epithelial tissue is divided on the basis of their structure in the basically four types. That is squamous epithelium, choroidal epithelium, columnar epithelium and pseudostratified epithelium. So what is squamous epithelium? A squamous epithelial structure is just like that. As we seen our tiles in home, the found tiles, and the structure of squamous epithelial is just like tiles. So it is also known as pavement epithelium. It is the structure of this. If it seen side view, it will flat structure, and if it see on the top view, it would be like a this. And where the squamous epithelium is formed? So it formed in alveoli of lungs, where the exchange of gases happens, in lining of blood vessel, that is endothelium, lining of Bowman's capsule, there would be formed squamous epithelium. So what is the work of squamous epithelium? So work of squamous epithelium is the diffusion. So whether it is a diffusion of gases, diffusion of any materials, so it would be formed there is squamous epithelial. Next, talk to choroidal epithelium. The structure of choroidal epithelium is like cube-like structure. You can see here. Cube-like structure is formed in choroidal epithelium. So the location of choroidal epithelium is gonads, salivary ducts, pancreatic duct. What is gonads? Gonads is a germinal epithelium where the ova and sperms are released. Means ova and sperms are formed. It's a help in the germinal epithelium. So another name of choroidal epithelium is a germinal epithelium. So it's choroidal epithelium. Its modification is found in cuboidal breast border epithelium. If in cuboidal structure there is a breast border like structure, so it will be called cuboidal breast border epithelium. And it is found in PCT of nephron, that is proximal convoluted tubule. And what is the work of cuboidal epithelium? Work of cuboidal epithelium is a secretion and absorption. If it is found in gland, then it is a secret, and if it is found in cilia, then it is absorb the material. Next, talk to columnar epithelium. As the name suggests, its structure would be a column-like structure, long cylinder column-like structure, and the nucleus is found inner part like that. And if it is a depression on this, then it would be work like gland. And if it is found in breast border, it will function like a secretion and absorption area. So where the columnar epithelium is found? It is found in lining of stomach, lining of intestine, lining of alimentary canal, and fallopian tube. Fallopian tube would be found if columnar epithelium has cilia. Then it is found, means a ciliated columnar epithelium is found in fallopian tube and respiratory tract, because there has to, means when ova is released, then fallopian tube have to take it, and with the help of cilia it is given there. So it is type of columnar ciliated epithelium. And next, pseudo stratified epithelium. Pseudo means false. So false epithelium means it just look like a multi-layer, but it is not multi-layer, it is single layer, but it is look like a multi-layer. So it is known as pseudo stratified epithelium. And so it is false, multi-layer. And types of pseudo stratified epithelium is non-ciliated and ciliated. So when the ciliated word is joined with any term, so its work is the taking out anything. Means it is found in trachea, large bronchi. And if we talk about non-ciliated pseudostratified epithelium, then it is found in duct of parotid and salivary gland. It's all about the simple epithelial tissue. And there is a modification in cuboidal and columnar epithelial. Means it acts like a glandular epithelial. So we will talk it later. So first we talk about compound epithelial tissue. Compound epithelial tissue definition is that there is a two or more cell layers are formed. And the function of compound epithelial tissue is protection, as it is seen in skin. So it is further divided into two types, that is stratified epithelium and transitional epithelium. First one is stratified and next transitional. So what the meaning of stratified epithelium? Means there is a multi-layer form. Means in a lower part it is formed columnar epithelium. In middle that is polygonal. And in upper part there is a squamous epithelium. So it is a layer, multiple layer. And based on this, it is further divided into two, that is keratinized and non-keratinized. Keratin, you know, that keratin is found in skin. So keratinized example is skin. And non-keratinized, it is found in weight area. Where is the weight area of our body? It is found in that area. So what is the weight area? That is cornea of eye, buccal cavity, it is always weight, pharynx, vagina, and tongue. So where will be weight area, there would be formed non-keratinized squamous stratified epithelial tissue. And next one is transitional epithelial. What is transitional epithelial? Transitional epithelial is a type of compound epithelium, and it is found in urinary system, and its another name is urinary urinary epithelial tissue. So it is found in urinary system, that is urinary bladder and ureter. And the another, that is modification of columnar and cuboidal epithelial, that is glandular epithelial. Gland is a part of organ, and glandular epithelial is divided into two, that is unicellular and multicellular. So if it is in unicellular, means a single layer of cell, then it is found in goblet cell. And if it is in multicellular, then it will be found in gastric gland, intestinal gland. And further on the bark of gland, it is divided into two parts, that is exocrine and endocrine. In exocrine, there is a duct present and it secretes saliva, mucus, tears, etc. And if it is an endocrine gland, then it secretes hormones, enzymes. And the organ which function as exo and endo, that is known as heterocrine gland, that is our pancreas. So it will talk about the in gland system. So means in gland, there is epithelial tissue formed. So what we have learned today, we have learned about the types of epithelial tissue and where it is formed. Hope you will like this video, and if you like this video, please share with your friends. And if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.